Welcome to another presentation about the Carolina Bays. This presentation examines whether artificial intelligence can produce graphical models that simulate the impacts that created the Carolina Bays. The Carolina Bays have a mathematically elliptical geometry, and this implies that they originated as inclined conical cavities or penetration funnels. The glacier ice impact hypothesis, published in 2017, proposes that an extraterrestrial impact on the Laurentide ice sheet ejected pieces of ice in ballistic trajectories, and the oblique impacts of the ice boulders created inclined conical cavities that became shallow elliptical depressions by viscous relaxation. In order to reach the east coast, the ice projectiles had to have speeds of 3 to 4 kilometers per second. In July of 2025, Dr. Michael Owen created the hydrocode simulation of the impact of an ice boulder with a diameter of 20 meters traveling at 1.8 kilometers per second at an angle of 35 degrees into a liquefied target. A link to the original video is given in the description below. The ice boulder disintegrated on impact, and the momentum of the ice pieces created a cavity with an uplifted rim. I wanted to know if artificial intelligence can produce graphical models that simulate the impacts that created the Carolina Bays without using expensive hydrocode modeling programs. In this evaluation, I used Grok from XAI and Copilot from Microsoft, although there were other choices like Gemini from Google, ChatGPT from OpenAI, and Claude from Anthropic. I gave Grok the following prompt. Create a 10-second video of the collision of a spherical ice boulder with a diameter of 20 meters and density of 917 kilograms per cubic meter impacting at an angle of 35 degrees into a target of unconsolidated liquefied soil with a density of 1,700 kilograms per cubic meter at a speed of 3,500 meters per second. The ice has a compressive strength of 15 megapascals and fracture propagation speed of 3,000 meters per second. After the transfer of momentum, the video must show the decrease of the depth of the cavity by viscous relaxation, taking into consideration that under Earth's gravitational force of 9.8 meters per second squared, the friction of the target will allow only 90% restoration of the original surface. Grok replied, Option 1, create the animation yourself. This sounds like something that an insubordinate employee would say. Grok seems to have an attitude problem and does not seem to know who is the boss. The reply continued, you can use free or open source software to create the described animation. Blender is a free 3D animation tool. You can model a 20-meter blue sphere, ice, and a brown plane, soil, animate the 35-degree impact at 3,500 meters per second, and particle effects for shattering using Blender's fracture modifier, and simulate the crater's 90% relaxation with a soft body or cloth simulation. The other options offered by Grok seemed more difficult to accomplish. I asked Grok to produce a script to use with Blender, and Grok generated a Python code program with these instructions. 1. Install Blender version 3.6 or later from blender.org. 2. Open Blender, start a new project. 3. Access text editor, in Blender switch to the scripting workspace. 4. Create new script, in the text editor click new and paste the script above. 5. Run script, click the Run script button. 6. Render animation, go to the Output Properties tab, ensure the output path is set, and click Render Animation. 7. Output the MP4 file will be saved to the specified path. If you need tweaks, such as different camera angles, more particles, or a specific output path, let me know. Unfortunately, the Python program generated by Grok had numerous errors that were due to the incompatibility of the code with the latest version that I downloaded from the Blender website. The attempts to correct the errors using AI suggestions fixed some problems but created other problems. I switched to Microsoft Copilot, and this time I specified in the prompt the version of Blender that I had installed. Copilot replied, Antonio, this is a beautifully rigorous request blending physics, material science, and animation into a single Blender script. Below is a Python program tailored for Blender 4.5.2 LTS that simulates the impact of a 20-meter ice boulder into liquefied soil, followed by viscous relaxation of the crater. It respects the physical parameters you provided and is structured for clarity and extensibility. Copilot is more polite than Grok, and it has been programmed to address the user by first name and praise them to create a congenial working relationship. The program worked, but unfortunately, it did not produce the desired results. I was very disappointed with the resulting video. The ice projectile was not visible, there was no impact, there was no crater. The level ground transformed into a field of small pyramids that eventually became level ground again. This was nothing at all like what had been promised in the Copilot response. I was not ready to give up. I gave Microsoft Copilot a new request. Calculate the kinetic energy of an ice sphere with a radius of 10 meters, density of 917 kilograms per cubic meter, and speed of 3,500 meters per second. Copilot understood this prompt correctly and referenced the formula for kinetic energy. Copilot correctly calculated the volume and the mass of the ice sphere and came up with the correct answer for the kinetic energy. It also mentioned that the energy released is equivalent to about 5.6 kilotons of TNT, which is definitely not something you would want crashing into your backyard. This is Copilot AI humor. Ha ha ha! Copilot offered to visualize the impact effects, and I agreed. This bar chart compares the kinetic energy of the ice boulder to the Hiroshima bomb and other nuclear bombs. The impact highlights also include an estimated crater diameter of about 3,963 meters, nearly 4 kilometers wide. This was astonishing. Meteor crater in Arizona is only about 1 kilometer wide, and it was created by a more energetic impact. I challenged Copilot. Your estimate of the crater diameter is too large. It should be about 100 meters according to the calculations from Professor Melosh. Copilot replied, "You are absolutely right, Antonio, and thank you for pointing that out with such precision. The estimate I gave earlier was based on a rough energy-to-crater scaling, which tends to overestimate for smaller gravity-dominated impacts. According to the University of Arizona's crater calculator developed by Professor J. Melosh and Rose Bayer, the pi scaling method is the most reliable for estimated crater size from projectile parameters." Copilot then concludes that the resulting crater diameter is indeed in the ballpark of 100 meters, not kilometers. This reflects the physics of gravity-dominated cratering, where the size scales sublinearly with energy due to material strength and gravitational constraints. Copilot then asks me, "Would you like to build a blender simulation using this corrected scale? We could animate the impact, ejecta curtain, and soil relaxation with cinematic fidelity." It was interesting to see Copilot try to justify its previous error. I could have asked for the source of the energy to crater scaling that it used, but my purpose was to create a working model rather than to expose the deficiencies of Copilot. I asked Copilot to provide the Python code for a Blender simulation. It replied, "Perfect, let's build a modular Blender Python script to simulate the impact of a 20-meter diameter ice sphere striking the target at 3,500 meters per second. This will include a sphere set up with correct mass and velocity, ground plane with displacement for crater formation, keyframed animation of impact, and optional soil relaxation and ejecta visualization." When the Blender visualization started, it showed an ice sphere approaching a surface at an angle of 90 degrees because I did not specify an oblique angle. I was finally getting some valid results. I was disappointed when the visualization concluded. Although I specified that the ice sphere had a speed of 3,500 meters per second, the visualization shows the ice boulder bouncing softly on the surface instead of crashing forcefully, fragmenting, and creating a crater. It seems like the artificial intelligence agent keeps forgetting the immediate context and does something similar, but wrong. It is as if you send your brother to buy apples and he comes back with lemons. Artificial intelligence needs to improve substantially before it is truly intelligent. The ability of AI to analyze a problem, provide guidance, and generate computer code is fairly good, but there are some glaring deficiencies. The programs try to show off their knowledge by providing information that is not requested, but the information is sometimes wrong or irrelevant. This was the case with the statement about the enormous size of the crater made by the 20-meter ice sphere. This type of behavior from an AI system is usually called a hallucination. The output of the AI programs is not checked for consistency with the real world. A simple comparison of the size of Meteor Crater in Arizona, which is just over 1 kilometer, could have raised some doubts about the size of the crater made by a 20-meter ice sphere. This information is in Wikipedia, which is a basic training set for AI programs. I'm not an expert in creating prompts for AI systems, but I expect that an AI program should be able to understand and implement a request that is rigorous and clear. At the pace at which artificial intelligence is being developed, I have no doubt that these programs will improve in the near future and they will be able to accomplish the tasks that we give them. Thank you for joining me in this study of the Carolina Bays. Ask your geology professors to discuss the Carolina Bays because they are the most prevalent geological structures in the Atlantic coastal plain. There's a link to the LiDAR visualization tool by Michael Davias in the description of the video. My book about the Carolina Bays is available at Amazon. Subscribe to my YouTube channel to be notified of future videos about the Carolina Bays and other scientific topics.